In this video, Human Health and Disease, we are going to learn about the diseases caused by protozoa, malaria and amoebiasis. Let's begin with malaria. Malaria is caused due to a pathogen, Plasmodium. The different species of Plasmodium are Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium malariae, Plasmodium ovale and Plasmodium falciparum. Of all these different variants, malignant malaria is caused by Plasmodium falciparum and it is very fatal. The organs affected by malaria are liver and red blood cells. What is the method of transmission or epidemiology? It is spread due to the bite of a female Anopheles mosquito which is acting as a vector. The vector is an organism which carries the pathogen. In the case of malaria, the vector is a female Anopheles mosquito and the pathogen is Plasmodium. What are the symptoms? It involves high fever and chill. Fever occurs in every alternate days and also vomiting. Let's study of the life cycle of a malarial parasite, that is Plasmodium. It is very interesting that the malarial parasite requires two hosts in order to complete its life cycle. The two hosts are a human being and a female Anopheles mosquito. The life cycle of the Plasmodium, it begins when the female Anopheles mosquito injects sporozoids when it bites a human being. It begins with sporozoids. And these sporozoids or the parasitic sporozoids initially it multiplies within the liver cells. And after that, it leaves the liver cells and attacks the red blood cells. And the red blood cells, after multiplication of the Plasmodium inside the red blood cells, it results in the rupture of the RBCs. The rupture of the RBCs, it releases a toxin. And the toxin substance is called as hemozoon. And as we learned earlier, that one of the symptoms of malaria is high fever and chill. And it is this hemozoon which is released into the blood which is responsible for the chill and high fever. From the infected human, the parasite enters into the body of the Anopheles mosquito, that is the second host, when it bites that infected human being and it takes its blood meal. And its further development or it completes its life cycle in the female Anopheles mosquito. The female Anopheles mosquito, it takes up in the form of gametocytes from the human body. The development of gametocytes further takes place in the mosquito's body where it forms gametes. We know gametes, they fuse together in the process called as fertilization, and the site of fertilization is the intestine or the gut of mosquito. Fertilization results in zygote. The zygote further develops into a large number of sporozoids, and from the intestine wall, the sporozoids migrate into the salivary gland of the mosquito. And next stage of the development of sporozoid takes place inside the human being, and the sporozoids are transferred into the human body when it bites a human being. Let's learn about the life cycle of the Plasmodium with the help of a diagram. The upper half represents its life cycle in the mosquito's body, and the lower half of the circle represents the life cycle in the human body. The life cycle starts when the female Anopheles mosquito injects sporozoids into a human body. The sporozoids enter into the liver cells, and from the liver cells, it is transported or transferred into the red blood cells. It multiplies within the red blood cells and forms gametocytes when the red blood cells ruptures. And in this gametocyte stage, it is transferred into the next host, that is the body of the mosquito, when the female Anopheles mosquito takes a blood meal. And the gametocytes, it develops into gametes in the wall of the gut or the alimentary canal, where it undergoes fertilization resulting in the formation of zygote. and the zygote develops into sporozoids. And from the gut wall, the sporozoids are transferred into the salivary gland of the mosquito. Again, when the mosquito bites another human being, the sporozoids enter into the human body. And thus, it requires two hosts. And in the human host, it undergoes asexual reproduction, whereas in the mosquito host, it undergoes sexual reproduction. And such organisms which require two hosts to complete its life cycle are called as digenetic. So we finished with malaria. The second disease which we have to study is amoebiasis, which is caused by the pathogen Amoeba entamoeba histolytica. And the other name for amoebiasis is amoebic dysentery. Okay. The organs affected are the large intestine of man. What are the methods of transmission? Here, the housefly acts as a vector. And with the help of this vector, it contaminates the water and food with the fecal matter and thus gains entry into a human body. And what are the symptoms? The symptoms include loose motion and abdominal pain, and the stools with excess mucus and blood clots. And this is a picture of entamoeba histolytica, which causes amoebiasis or amoebic dysentery.